Have you ever wanted a magic wand that can make things levitate? Yeah, me too. Welcome to Impossible Science. Hey everyone, it's Jason Latimer, world champion of magic, coming to you with another Impossible Science. Now, with the magic in the air, I thought it'd be fun to do an episode on levitation. And, well, I've got bad news. What you just saw with this wand was a trick. It was an illusion, and this is just a prop. But it doesn't mean we can't build a wand that will actually make something levitate. That's right. All we need is a piece of PVC pipe. The thinner the wall, the better. About 2 feet long, so ask your family or if you have any lying around the house or if you can go to a hardware store and grab some. Then you'll need some wool. Now you can actually use a Santa hat, or if you don't have a Santa hat, just need some actual wool, all right? Probably about a 1 foot square would be fine. And then lastly, you need some tinsel. Now, you don't need much of this. So if you happen to see some lying around or during the holidays, if you just grab a bag of it, you'll have enough to last you the rest of your life. So all we need now is some empty space. So let's go make the magic happen. First, we have to build up a charge of static electricity. Now, you're probably familiar with shocking your friends by rubbing your feet on the floor, or if you rub a balloon against your shirt and you stick it to the wall. But in this case, we're gonna build up a charge, and then we're gonna transfer the same charge to this piece of tinsel, and then they'll repel, because like charges repel. And it looks like that. And if I can get a bigger charge, I can get it to float a little bit higher. So what's going on? Well, it's not magic, it's science. Let me explain. Atoms have three parts, protons, neutrons, and electrons. The protons have a positive charge, and the electrons have a negative charge. And the neutrons, well, they're neutral. By rubbing the PVC pipe and the wool together, it robs the electrons from the wool and sticks them to the PVC pipe. The result is a surplus of electrons on the PVC pipe, which makes it negatively charged. When the tinsel touches that negatively charged PVC pipe, it picks up that negative charge too. And now both the tinsel and the PVC pipe have the same charge, making them repel each other. Opposites attract, but like charges repel, and in this case, it's like charges that is making our tinsel levitate. Okay, now that we understand what's going on, let me show you how to actually make this experiment. You're gonna need about a 10 inch by 10 inch square of wool. You're gonna need some clear tape, some scissors, some tinsel, and a PVC pipe. Now the PVC pipe should be about 24 inches long, and you're gonna want the thinnest walled PVC pipe you can find. That will actually help you build up your static charge, okay? Now I'm gonna show you how to make the orb. Now, after doing this 1,000 times for my museums, I've learned a couple tricks. So the idea is we just need to take three strands and tie them at the top and the bottom, but there is a little trick to it. So the first thing is take three strands, take some tape, and tape them together. Now it'll be easier to work with. Take these and tie them into a knot. Perfect. Just a regular knot there. Pull your fingers out and pull the knot through. All right, so the knot's right there. We don't want all this excess. We want to cut that off so that we can keep it as light as possible. Now this experiment is easy to make, but very hard to master. So I would strongly recommend starting off with a smaller orb and building up to it. So I'm gonna start off with one about 4 or 5 inches about here, okay? Now you can, using this, you can actually tie another knot because it's easier to hold onto because it's got that little knot in it. Or you can do the same thing with the tape, tape the ends and cut that off. I'm actually gonna do the tape, the end, so I don't have all this excess I have to figure out how to navigate. So I'm gonna take this, put this about here, cut off these ends. All right. Now I'm gonna tape these three ends together. Now you want them roughly the same length because when the orb inflates because of static electricity, then we're gonna want them to actually inflate evenly. Sometimes if you don't have enough of a static charge, it doesn't inflate evenly, but that's okay. All right, so I'm gonna take this, tie this into a knot here. Great. So now I've got a knot there, and I've got a knot there, and I'm gonna cut the excess off here. And that's it, that's all you need. Now, I usually make a few more of these just when I do the experiment, that way if I lose one, I don't have to stop everything I'm doing. And if you have friends, grab a couple more PVC pipes because it's a lot of fun to go back and forth to see how long you can keep it up in the air. All right, you can hear the crackling sound of the static charge building up. Now, if you don't have a strong enough charge, it'll actually attract to the PVC pipe. So, and you might see that happen if you're not building up a strong enough charge. The solution? Well, charge it more. Oh, and by the way, if you live in a place where it's really rainy or humid, it's a little bit harder to build up a static charge on a PVC pipe. So just letting you know, if it's raining outside, this might be really difficult to do. Let's try again. Well, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed making a magic wand that can make objects levitate through science. And if you enjoy my goofy experiments and magic, let me know by clicking the like button and subscribing to the channel. And until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything. The real secret